We continue our month-long series, Weather 101, with the answers to the most often asked questions about weather and some amazing facts. Today, if lightning actually strikes the surface of a lake, how far does that electricity from that strike actually travel? Well, if you're a boater or lifeguard or just want to be out on the water, this is one of those questions that has probably come to you at one time or another. While there are no definitive answers to this, some indirect research has told us a few things. First, lightning is more attracted to salt water than fresh water because of it essentially spreads out with more minerals in it. It also hits the surface of the water and spreads out in all directions, and even fish can be affected by that if they're close to the surface. And then the charge, as it disperses in all directions on the surface of the water, it gradually weakens. So if lightning hits the middle of a lake, not everyone in the entire lake is struck. Exactly how far from the bolt has never been officially documented, but judging from past history, you are generally safe from the direct effects from a lightning bolt after 25 to 30 feet. This means the bottom line advice is the same. If a storm approaches, seek shelter and get out of the water.
Don't test it.
Yeah. That's right. Tomorrow on Weather 101, during the first day of spring or fall, known as the equinox, most of the Earth has equal daylight. But why is it 12 hours and 8 minutes and not just 12 hours? Where does the 8 minutes come from? That's tomorrow in Weather 101.
Interesting.
Well, you were just showing some video of